Most simply, conditional wait variables allow you to take one thread off the scheduling queue until there is a signal from another thread that it should be put back on. This is useful if we don't want one thread to continue its work until the work of another thread is finished. To give an example, let's suppose that we have a thread A over here and a thread B over here. Thread B wants to stop until thread A's work is done. Now, to use a conditional wait variable, we need three things: a variable indicating whether the work is done or some other condition that can be tested in memory, a lock that we can apply to this variable, and a special conditional wait variable. Now, after finishing the work, thread A is going to acquire the lock, change is done to true, and then send a signal to anyone waiting on this condition, a signal that they should wake up, and then he'll unlock the lock. Thread B, for his part, will first acquire the lock and then check to see if the work is done. If it isn't, he will wait. Now, it is important that this conwait not only makes thread B wait, but it also unlocks the mutex. This will allow thread A to acquire the lock and eventually send the signal. The call blocks until the signal is received and thread B acquires the lock again, hence the need to unlock it at the end of the code. At first, this might seem unnecessarily complicated. Why do we need this if statement before the conwait procedure call, for instance? Well, if it weren't there, then it's possible that the signal will have already come, and we would never see it. So it's important to check that there's something to wait for before you actually wait. Given that there is such a condition to check, we'd better also have a lock for it. Otherwise, we might decide that we need to wait, but before we actually execute the wait function, the signal might come. And of course, the conwait method had better unlock the mutex, otherwise thread A would never be able to acquire it and change the condition that we're waiting on.